I'm Mrs. Painter. Welcome to my kitchen. We've been blessed with a lot of figs this year on our tree. So today we're going to do another recipe. And this recipe comes from the all new Ball Book of Canning and Preserving. I'll be sure to include a link to the book as well as a little type up for you on the recipe. We're not going to do exactly how they did it. Their recipe is called Fig Rosemary and Red Wine Jam. We're actually going to use balsamic in ours. So while our jars are boiling, let's go ahead and chop up our figs and get the first step of this going. We're going to need to steep our balsamic and our rosemary for 30 minutes. And I've got everything all measured and ready to go besides the figs. I find it's a lot easier when you're doing a canning project if you have everything together. So this was 1.5 cups of balsamic vinegar, and I have some sprigs of rosemary. It's approximately 2 tablespoons. And let's just get this up to temperature here. While this is going, we're going to chop up our figs. Before we moved to the desert in southern Nevada, I had no idea how wonderful figs were. I'd had a dried fig, wasn't that impressed with it, but these fresh figs are amazing. We often just have a slice or two of them with our breakfast. So this recipe calls for finely chopped figs. They're super ripe, so I think they're gonna break down pretty easily. The whole fig is edible. You don't need to blanch, peel any part of it. Just remove the stem. So as we go here, we'll just add it to our measuring cup. I haven't found a whole lot of recipes for figs. Most of them are baking and jams. And so I try to eat as many of them fresh as possible. I also like to dehydrate them. It makes a super nice snack over the winter months when you don't have any figs because your tree is dormant. Might try a Fig Newton recipe. I almost forgot about that. And figs actually have a lot of their own natural pectin, but this recipe actually calls for 3 tablespoons of the Ball Classic Pectin. And I'm guessing it's because we're going to be adding this balsamic vinegar, which is pretty acidic. And this recipe is going to make 4 half pints. And I have an extra little jar because I want to, well, it's always good to have an extra jar, but I also want to put a little bit into it so we can taste it and see if we like it. This recipe is using rosemary. But I think it would be really good to try it with lavender. They're so ripe, they almost mush. Let's give our balsamic and our rosemary a little stir here. I can smell the rosemary now, so I think we got the temperature up high enough. And let's just take a look at these figs. A little bit more. So for the balsamic and the rosemary, we want to let that go for 30 minutes. That will ensure that the flavor of the rosemary is infused into the balsamic. And we also have fresh rosemary growing in our garden. If you live in the desert of southern Nevada, rosemary practically volunteers. Alright, our jars have sterilized, and I'm just going to turn this down to low and see if we can bring that boil down. I'm going to keep the jars hot. I like to keep the water hot when I'm making jam as well, because I don't want to have to wait too long to get the jars up to temperature. Actually, I might just shut this off because it's still boiling. I don't want to have to wait too long to get the jars up to temperature. The more time your jars are in the heat, the more opportunity you have for the pectin to break down. Last year I made a jam with the figs using lemons and apricots, and because the pectin content is so high in the figs, I didn't have to add any extra pectin. And it had a more of a lemony flavor, but it was really very delicious. All right, I think we have enough figs here. I'm gonna go ahead and pause the video while we let our balsamic steep, and we'll be back. Our timer is going off, so we can go ahead and turn off the heat on our balsamic and rosemary. Now it's time to strain the rosemary out of the balsamic vinegar. So let's go ahead and switch these pots around. We're using a fine mesh strainer. And this is a really small batch of jelly or jam, but because it's going to have to come up to a full rolling boil, I went ahead and got a slightly larger container for this. Now this next part is going to go much faster. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and add in our figs, pectin, and lemon juice. So these things are combined now, so we're going to want to bring this up to a high boil. We want it to be a boil that cannot be stirred down, so let's turn this heat up. And we're going to want to keep stirring this because we don't want it to burn. While we were bringing our balsamic and rosemary to a simmer, I went ahead and got the jars out, as this next part is going to go pretty quick and we want our jars ready. Let's just turn our water back on so we can keep that nice and hot. And if you ever have an electric pressure cooker that breaks and goes bad, don't throw away those metal inserts. These things have a thick bottom and they are wonderful for small canning projects like this. The thicker the bottom, the less likely you are to burn what you're making. It's a really pretty color, kind of burgundy, with chunks of figs. I'm Maybe the only caveat of a thick bottom is it takes longer to heat up, but it's, the little extra time is worth it to avoid burning your batch. And I have this on relatively high heat. It's not all the way up on high, but it's pretty high. As soon as we get this up to a high boil, we are going to add the sugar. And once we add the sugar, we're only going to let it boil hard again for 1 minute. Of course, we have to bring it back up to boil, but that should happen pretty quickly. We've got a little bit of a boil going on right now. It's not a high boil, but it's getting there. See a lot of the seeds separating out. The seeds are really soft in the figs and they're very flavorful. It's actually the really ripe part that's so yummy, so you don't have to worry about seeds in this type of recipe. If you're looking for a project and you don't have a whole lot of time, this is actually a good project. It's not as time consuming as some of the canning recipes that I do. And it's really quite easy. We're getting there. All right, let's go ahead and add our sugar. Stirred in good. All right, we're just waiting for this to come back up to high boil, and then we'll turn on our timer for 1 minute. Have our water on a low setting in the back so it'll be nice and hot. Gets a little toasty in here this time of the year. All right, starting to see a little boiling action. Very thick. I wasn't sure when I was stirring the sugar in if I was going to get that all stirred in, but it actually did dissolve. We're almost to a high boil. Alright, let's go ahead and turn our timer on for 1 minute. Only 4 seconds to go. Pull our jars over close. All right, heat off. Timer off. Let's get this jam in the jars. This canning funnel makes all the difference in the world. Nice dark reddish color here. And one more. Be helpful to put a glove on at this point. We have just enough to put in our little jar, so we'll be able to sample this. I like to wipe the rims with this. It helps make sure you have a good clean surface and reduces the risk of your lids not sticking and sealing properly. Now we're ready to put our lids on and our rings. Let's get this water going good back there. It worked out pretty nice that this was a small batch, only because I haven't made this before. And it's just nice to try a small amount when you're doing it for the first time. And the next step is we're going to want to put our jars in using this nice little device. This helps keep you from burning yourself. It gives you a good grip on your jars. Basically, it's a necessity, I would say, for canning. And this worked out perfectly because our water is nice and hot. And we have a good inch of water above the tops of the jars. Let's get this going a little bit more and we'll turn on our timer. All right, we're going to set our timer for 10 minutes. And we'll be back as soon as it's done. All right, our timer's going off. Let's turn off this heat, turn off our timer, and take our lid off. Now, I personally have never done it this way before, but Ball is the expert, so let's do what they say. Their directions are to turn off the heat, remove the lid, let stand 5 minutes, remove from pot, let cool. So while these jars were boiling, I went ahead and toasted myself some of our sunflower seed bread, and I just want to try a little bit of this jam. Let's see how it tastes. Looks like it's going to set up really nicely. I don't personally have much of a sweet tooth, so it's probably going to be a little sweeter than I would like. But let's try it. Let's see what it tastes like. Okay, here goes. Very good. Thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe and follow along with me. Thank you.